I'm going to talk about using Meshtastic with T-Deck after a long time. Yeah, it's been a while. This is my old friend T-Deck. I love this form factor, so I really like this device. Let me turn it on. The UI is a fancy version of the UI made by another user. If the existing UI was MS-DOS, this one feels like Windows. It's very cool. Let's put it aside for a moment. This is T-Deck Plus, which adds a GPS module, built-in battery, and housing shell to the existing T-Deck. Look at this, the product itself looks solid. Since it already includes a battery, you can probably only take this with you. When I power up the device, I have pre-installed the same version of Meshtastic on this device. It seems that there's currently no official firmware for T-Deck Plus, so I have installed the firmware for T-Deck for now. Again, it looks great. To turn on the keyboard backlight, just press Alt and B button. The white keyboard looks pretty, but I feel like it will get dirty quickly if I don't clean it often. In the settings menu, you can change settings such as the device name, region, mode, and preset. In addition, you can also change the overall settings of the application. What I need now is to set the screen timeout, because it's inconvenient when the screen turns off during testing. I'm currently using the firmware for T-Deck, and it seems that the touch interrupt isn't working properly. Touch works, but it's very slow. There will be new firmware for T-Deck Plus sooner or later. Going back to T-Deck and try the same settings. The screen is off because the screen timeout is only 60 seconds. That's why I need to set the screen timeout first. As you can see, T-Deck responds to screen touch events without any delay. It's much faster. Okay, now let's try sending a message. I have already created a channel called My Network for testing messages. Let's send the message through this channel. When the message is sent and acknowledged, the border color of the message changes. I like this detail. T-Deck Plus also received the message sent by T-Deck because it is in the My Network channel. I will send the message with this too. Did you hear the beep sound? That's a notification that there is a new message on T-Deck. On the right is my iPhone with T-Beam is connected. I already covered this in the previous video, so if you need more detail for this, please check it out. Actually, when a message is sent from T-Deck and T-Deck Plus, a notification should appear on the screen here too. Sometimes the notification doesn't appear. Looking at the messages received here, only one of the two was received. I think I need to update the firmware version of my T-Beam. Anyway, I'm gonna send the message here. Did you hear the beep sound at the same time? The message was received normally on both devices. Works well. I will send the message again. I received the message on T-Deck and received the same message on my iPhone. As you can see here, the message transfer is smooth and fun. I think the reason it's even more fun is probably the new UI. This UI works well with T-Deck and is a huge help in making sending and receiving messages. Also, it's easy to set up, which I guess is the power of UI. Look at this, there are a lot of people using Meshtastic in my area. I have had it on for about an hour and now 72 nodes are being discovered. I can see a lot of clients and a lot of routers. The main menu provides a more intuitive view of the current locations of active nodes. This time, let's send a message to a specific node. This is a node of the T-Deck Plus. if I send a message to this, of course, only TDEC Plus received this message. I think it's really nice that this pop-up appears when you receive a message on the home screen. It doesn't seem to take you to the chat screen when you press it, but it still is great. Through that chat menu, you can check the messages. I will also send the message only to my iPhone here again. This time, the notification worked well and I can check it on my Apple Watch. I simply sent a thumbs up emoji, but unfortunately, AirVisual does not support emojis yet, so it does not display. As you can see, Meshtastic's new UI seems to make off-grid communication based on LoRa more free. This fancy UI version is not official yet, but it seems that it will be supported in the official version sooner or later. I hope so. This is for those who want to try the fancy version of Meshtastic. Since this is not the official version, you need to install the UI updated version separately after installing the firmware. In the action tab, you will find the fancy TDEC item. From here, download the two files, the firmware file and the TDEC firmware file. These are the files you need to prepare. If there is a new version, please try it. There will be updates. Let's install the main firmware from Meshtastic's Flasher page. You must install using the firmware you downloaded. Now let's get the TDEC Plus into boot mode. Simply hold down the trackball and press the reset button. There was an issue with this part in TDEC, but the new version makes it very easy to get into boot mode. That's good. Now select the connected serial port and the flashing will begin. This completes the main firmware installation. Now we need to install the update firmware for the new UI. Since it is already in boot mode, connect right away and prepare for download. This time, unzip the downloaded TDEC firmware zip file and select the update.bin file. For UI, the starting address is 0x10000. I felt once again how important embedded UI development is. This is really fun and I think it can change a lot of things for the better. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.